The deadly bombardment of Lugansk, Ukraine's second largest city in the east, has put the metropolis on a war footing. Air raid sirens blare constantly to warn citizens of imminent attacks. This video appears to show the city coming under rocket fire, appearing to rule out any intention by the authorities of targeting strikes. Following the attack, we visited a pensioner whose house had been destroyed.
Все, все своими руками, мозолями. И теперь вот это произошло. А теперь что я буду делать? По новой делать? Или умирать уже мне? Хай бомбят уже дальше.
The president of Ukraine has now signed off on a military plan to take the east by force. RT's Maria Finoshna is in the shell-shocked city of Lugansk for us.
We hear sounds of artillery every day, many times a day, and we can also say that while both sides claim that they are not targeting and they will not target residential areas, we can say that it often happens. This is why me and my cameraman now, we have to work in flak jackets, although we are in the city center. Just on Monday, a shell landed not far from where we are now, just blocks away from the city center, hitting a car, and reportedly the driver of this car was killed at the scene. The operation leadership in Kyiv also claims that heavy artillery or aviation will not be used in attacks on big cities such as Lugansk or Donetsk, but we can say that we hear airplanes overflying this area almost every day again. And while eyewitnesses say that they are behind last week attacks on two tiny villages 25 kilometers north of Lugansk, when at least 7 civilians were killed, including a 5-year-old boy. The army leadership also claims that the cities of Donetsk and Lugansk will soon be besieged, so that the anti-government forces accumulating inside will be sealed with no chances to get any support from anywhere outside. This is why local fighters are currently on high alert, fortifying their checkpoints. And we also hear that several bridges in the area were damaged, which could be their attempt to stop the Ukrainian troops.
The last week has seen government forces take back control of several cities. Since then, Kyiv's military has reportedly begun a full-blown purge, arresting local police and young men en masse. A video has also emerged of a radical right Ukrainian deputy threatening a bound elderly man.
А сепаратісти що в тебе робили?
У мене не було нікого.
А ти що робив?
Я робив, щоб школа робила, дитсадики.
Всі ви так розказуєте. Все. На 15 років у тюрму. Скільки років тобі?
62.
62 плюс 15. 77 років. Вийдеш у 80. Якщо доживеш.
A local resident told us how it feels to remain in Slavyansk now the city has been taken by government forces.
They go from street to street, from flat to flat, and it's all about arrests. They've arrested the entire police force and drove all the personnel to God knows where. We have no idea what's happening to them. People who are supposedly supporting the anti-government movement are missing. They don't answer the phones, and no one knows what's going on with them. You'd be putting your life in danger if you tried to find that out.